Hello students, welcome to Easy Science YouTube channel. Please do subscribe to Easy Science YouTube channel and click the bell icon. You will never miss an update from my channel. Please do share my video. So let's move on to the class today. In today's class, we will discuss about physiology of digestion. So let's move on to the class. It's physiology of digestion. So basically, what do you mean by digestion? What digestion means? See, breakdown of complex non-diffusible substances into simple diffusible substances is known as digestion. That's a very simple definition. Breakdown of complex non-diffusible substances into simple diffusible substances is known as digestion. But how this conversion of complex substances into simple substances takes place? That is both mechanical and chemical process. Digestion is both mechanical and chemical process. Yes. So mechanical process means what and chemical process means what? Mechanical process. Mechanical means whenever you eat the food is cut and crushed by our teeth. Yes, and it converted into small particles. Right. So this is cutting and crushing, and even there were several muscles in the alimentary tract which produces a special movement known as peristalsis. So the cutting and crushing and the peristalsis together known as the mechanical digestion. I mean mechanical part of the digestion. And what is the chemical part of digestion? We have different digestive glands were secreted inside the alimentary canal or our digestive tract, which contains different kinds of enzymes. So these enzymatic reactions will comes under chemical process. So digestion is both mechanical and chemical process. Right. So remember children, the breakdown of the complex substances into simple substances will be takes place in only the three parts of the alimentary canal. Very easy to remember, right? Only three parts it happens. One is mouth. Second one is stomach. And the third one is small intestine. Yes, in only the three parts, this breakdown will take place. So let's discuss what type of breakdown will take place. I mean, what type of mechanical process takes place and what type of chemical process will take place in the three parts. Let's move. Right. We know that the first part of our alimentary canal is mouth. So let's start with mouth only, children. So what happens inside the mouth? Let's discuss. Mouth. Mouth is known to be the first part of our digestive system. And basically, two important processes will take place inside the mouth. What are the two important processes that will take place inside the mouth? One is mastication. So this mastication will facilitate swallowing. Mastication will facilitate swallowing. And this process technically we call it as deglutition. Right. So now, what is mastication? Right. So whenever you eat food, what happens? food is cut and crushed by our teeth, and there were 3 pairs of salivary glands inside the oral cavity. They will secrete the digestive juice known as saliva. So what happens is during the process of mastication, or what is mastication? So first point is, yes, the important point, yes, food is cut and crushed by our 4 different kinds of the teeth. Then it is thoroughly mixed with the saliva. Which is mixed with saliva? The food is mixed with the saliva. So this process, this whole process together, we call it as mastication. Food is cut and crushed by our 4 different kinds of the teeth, and it is thoroughly mixed with the saliva. This process we call it as mastication. As food is cut and crushed by our teeth, what happens, children? So food will be converted into smaller particles, right? When you break a chalk, this what happens? They get separated, right? Now the food has cut into smaller particles. Now what happens? Each and every particle will go into the next part of the alimentary canal? No. For this only, saliva will secrete mucus. Yes, saliva will secrete mucus. What is the function of this mucus? Mucus will adhere the masticated particles. See, due to mastication, the food is converted into smaller particles. So these smaller particles, we call it as masticated particles. This mucus will adhere these masticated particles together. This is the function of the mucus, children. Saliva also secrete mucus. We have discussed that in digestive glands, it is help in easy movement of the food into the next part of the alimentary canal. Not only that, children, it also helps in adhering the masticated particles together. So this is the mechanical process of digestion that takes place inside the mouth. So what chemical process will take place inside the mouth? So remember, children, both chemical process and mechanical process will be takes place or will be started inside the mouth only. We know that saliva is the digestive juice secreted by the digestive gland, salivary glands. Now we know what is the function of the digestive juices. They contain some enzymes. So first of all, saliva contains some salts, children. Like we have ions are present, like sodium ions are present, potassium ions are present, chloride ions are present, and even bicarbonate ions are present inside the saliva. Then enzymes, there were 2 enzymes, children, remember. How many enzymes are present in the digestive juice saliva? 2 enzymes are present. One is salivary amylase, which is also known as tyalin, and the second one is lysozyme. So there were 2 enzymes present inside the saliva. So what is the action of these enzymes? So on which complex molecule this salivary amylase will act? So salivary amylase acts on carbohydrates, most complex molecules in our food. So that is starch. So they were polysaccharides, children. Technically they were known as polysaccharides. So by the action of this enzyme, these polysaccharides are converted into disaccharides called maltose. That is, starch will be converted into maltose, and the pH will be maintained at 6.8. Now, what is the action of this second enzyme? Lysozyme is an antibacterial enzyme. The food we eat contain different kinds of bacteria which can causes different kinds of diseases, children. So this lysozyme is an antibacterial enzyme which kills the bacteria present inside the food we eat. So that this lysozyme will prevent some infections which enter into our body through the food. So this will happens inside the mouth. This is a mechanical process and this is the chemical process that takes place inside the mouth. So let's move on to the next part, that is stomach. Now, one more point I forgot to explain you, that after mastication, the food was cut and crushed by our teeth, and even it is thoroughly mixed with saliva, and even some amount of polysaccharides like starch was converted into disaccharides. Now the food present in the mouth is technically known as bolus. Now this bolus will go to the next part of the alimentary canal, that is it enters into the stomach. So what happens to the food inside the stomach? We know stomach secretes a digestive juice known as gastric juice. So whenever the bolus enters into the stomach, so what happens? There were muscles on the wall of the stomach, muscles are present. Due to this muscles, churning action takes place. So this is the mechanical process which takes place inside the stomach. Churning action takes place so that the bolus is thoroughly mixed with the digestive juice, gastric juice. So here the most important point is the gastric juice contains an acid known as hydrochloric acid. So due to the liberation of hydrochloric acid, first of all the medium inside the stomach will be converted into acidic medium with a pH value of 1.8. Now, there are two functions for hydrochloric acid. Why this much of strong acid was entering or liberating into our stomach, whose pH value is 1.8, it's a strong acid. So, what is the reason? The reason is gastric juice contains some inactive enzymes, children. The inactive enzymes are pepsinogen and prorenin. Pepsinogen and prorenin. These inactive enzymes can converted into active enzymes only in the presence of acid. That is, this will happen only in acidic medium. So this inactive pepsinogen will be converted into pepsin. Autocatalysis takes place, that is the pepsin liberated can able to convert the remaining pepsinogen into active pepsin. Now prorenin will be converted into renin. Remember, these two are proteolytic enzymes, that means the enzymes which acts on proteins. Now how they were converted by, like how the proteins are converted by the action of these enzymes. So pepsin, due to the pepsin, proteins are converted into, by the action of the pepsin, proteins are converted into proteases and peptones. Proteases are the compounds which are formed due to the breakdown of proteins, and proteases are more complex when compared to the peptones. Now, what is the function of the renin? Remember, children, renin will be present only in the gastric juice of infants. So they act on a milk protein called casein. Renin act on a milk protein called casein in the presence of calcium ions. So this you have to remember. This reaction takes place only in the presence of calcium ions and converted into calcium para seizinate. Right. Now this calcium para seizinate with the help of the enzyme pepsin converted into proteases and peptones. Now this process of conversion of milk protein seizin into calcium para seizinate in the presence of renin and calcium ions is known as curdling of milk children. It is known as curdling of milk. Now a large quantity of mucus is secreted inside the stomach in order to protect the stomach from the action of its own acids, and even some bicarbonates also liberated which can have the buffer action and even prevent the acidity inside the stomach. So this will happen inside the stomach. So now let's move on to the next part and the last part where complex breakdown of complex substances takes place, that is small intestine. So what happens inside the small intestine? Let's discuss. Small intestine. Yes. So there are lot of movements, a large number of movements will be takes place from the walls of the small intestine by the layer muscularis externa. So these movements will help the, now one more point I forgot to explain. Now inside the stomach the food is now after digestion of the proteins, the food will goes to the next part of the alimentary canal, that is small intestine. But now inside the stomach the food is known as partially digested food, because already carbohydrate digestion started inside the mouth and protein digestion has completed, not completed, has started inside the stomach. So this is known as partially digested food, and this partially digested food from the stomach we call it as chyme. Now this chyme will enters into the small intestine. So due to the movements of the walls of the small intestine, the chyme is thoroughly mixed with the secretions called bile juice. Secretions of small intestine, one is bile juice, second one is pancreatic juice, and the third one is intestinal juice. So the intestinal juice is also known as succus entericus. Succus entericus. Now you know that the last part of the stomach will be opens into the first part of the small intestine, that is duodenum. The cells, the walls of the duodenum secrete a large amount of bicarbonates, so that the acidity or acidic nature which is present in the chyme will be changes into alkaline, and the pH inside the small intestine will be, it's 7.8 children, it's alkaline. It's very important because pancreatic juice and intestinal juice will act on the complex substances and convert them into simple substances only in the alkaline medium. So this is the physiology of digestion takes place inside the mouth, stomach and small intestine. I hope you all like the video. Please do like, share, subscribe to Easy Science YouTube channel and click the bell icon. You will never miss an update from my channel. Thank you.